previously on Candice and Cooky.
Who is this? Don't zoom in. What is that? Oh my gosh.
Look like dog
food. Thanks. Thanks. This thing again, though. You can't believe it.
Yeah, she got mystery meat on her plate.
Let me show you what Candice is eating. This is what she's eating, right? You can see everything.
Wait.
Love is an unconditional commitment to an imperfect person. To love somebody isn't just a strong feeling, it's a decision, a judgment, and a promise.
All right. Okay.
Baby, she must be in the atrium doing physical therapy. I'll head that way.
Met any of you?
Here she is. She was in physical therapy.
Sorry, I'm a little bit late. Would you mind introducing yourself so I have a sense of who's here?
Sure. Hi, I'm Carol.
Carol, okay.
I'm Eric.
All right. Carol, Eric, and what was it?
Nicola.
Okay. We have one more around.
Oh yeah, she's not.
Yeah, I try to get out of therapy.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. All right. Awesome. So then we get started with a little bit of a warm up, right?
Okay.
All right. Let's get started with that. Look over to your left. And back to the center. And bring your left ear down to your left shoulder. So you're feeling a little stretch in the opposite side of your neck. And back up. And down to the other side. Up. Then down to your chest. Just go ahead, just make sure you're locked so that your chair is not wobbling. Yeah, lock that, there you go. Yeah. Good, going forward, starting off small, like we're going around little grapes. And make them a little bigger, like you're going around a baseball. And let's go like basketball size. And then big. The first way is what you were just showing, where you start with your arms straight out in front of you, bend in, straighten out. You can always use that other hand to kind of help hold that arm up, because it takes a lot of shoulder work to hold the arm at the same time. A second option would be have your body forward just a tad, your arms back a little bit, and then you're bending and straightening the elbow. So the only thing moving is my elbow, right? My shoulder's not invited, but it hurts. Okay? And then the third option would be overhead. If you have any shoulder pain, any shoulder injuries, any shoulder discomfort, I wouldn't recommend this position because it does put your shoulder in the most kind of unstable or awkward position. But if no issues there, you can try this way. And then you're bending and straightening the elbow. There. Right? So you can try whichever one feels best for you. I'll probably do this one today. But feel free to try any one. We'll help you out with form. You ready? Got your position. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So if you didn't have this chair, I would say move your arm farther, but with the chair, it's not really possible. So
14, 15.
Good. Alright, over to the other side. Ready? One. Two. Three. Yeah, yeah, here. Hold it by this part. There. Yeah, there you go.
Six. Seven. Eight. Nine.
Here. And then straight. From there.
11.
So when you're in, then your arm is basically parallel over your leg. You're in, and you're straight out.
Three more of those, and then we'll hop back in the chair.
Baby has a lot of cool toys.
How you want the bed? Is that funny? How do you want the bed?
Hey, Stink.
How stinks?
Yeah.
How stinks? So what was going on at the Whirling Twirls dancing last night?
What you mean? That's how you gonna do me?
Mm-hmm. I saw the outfit.
I'm grown.
I know they wouldn't bring no soap. I'm not so deep in my soap.
You know, too. She had to get a breathing treatment. Is it helping?
My medicine is kicking in, and I just ate.
Uh-oh.
Night-night.
I'm giving her a recap of my evening out celebrating DC Pride. I'm paying for it today. I'm broke down. Nope.
This is our version of the hookah bar.
Really, see?
NRH. Yeah, what is it? NRC hookah bar.
NRH hookah, oh. Hookah bar.
We getting vape. Vaping to the next level, you know what I mean?
It's because that I'm doing so well. I'm doing so well with the hip, with the back pain. And now I have to hurry up and get this hip thing done because they were saying it can track the blood. The blood clot can travel to my heart. And now they started me on this new medicine where they give me a shot every morning at 6 a.m. in my stomach. It's a blood thinner. And I talked to Donisha about it. She said, Auntie, they gave you that because you have a blood clot. And then when I was talking to the doctors, they was like, Ms. Jones, unfortunately, you got to find somebody to get that out of there immediately. And it was like, what is your doctor's plans? And they said, also, you're dealing with your back, too. I be feeling like, what did I do so wrong? I've been good to people. You know, I did stuff in my past, in my youth. But I thought I made it up by being kind and nice and giving to people. Did I do such a bad job of neglecting my body? I mean, I was healthy working out until my late 30s, well, mid-30s. And then once I kept having these surgeries, I got depressed and I didn't care anymore about working out or what I put in my body anymore. I said, what's the point when I got to keep going back underneath the knife? I'm not going to be able to play basketball no more. You know, I was in my mindset, I was thinking like, why I gotta be healthy eating and doing all of this and staying in shape, you know?
All right. I really hate to see her have to go through so much, and it hurts me because I can't do anything to help. And I'm trying so hard to be strong for her. So, I didn't cry until I got out here in the car. it's really rough for me. I just wanted to catch a break, you know? She's been through so much.
next week on Candice and Cooky.
Wait, my pants ain't right.
Well, it's on video.
No, stinks.
Ain't no stink. This is candidly Candice and Cooky. Wait, why low?
Stop.
Beep.
Stop.
Beep.
Beep.
Beep. Beep. Beep. Turn on the light. Turn on the whole light. What do you need the sweater for? It's nobody in here but me and you now. And I asked you, remember? I said, nah, I'm going to leave the sweater in here just in case.
Baby, I said put it across.
No, what did you tell me? You said, no, I don't need it.
Baby, it's chilly. I need a sweater.
Nope. This is all on camera. She think because she was served like the Princess of Zamunda over in NRH that she gonna get that same treatment here. Nah. I got a nice bottle room temperature water over here. But she's like, baby, I don't want to be a prima donna, but can you give me some ice water? No.